go behind me.
You know, another way to do that is do a time lapse.
Okay, wait a minute. I'm just to do a video up to you. It's amazing. Okay, stop. Well, here we go. Into the oasis. I think someone's flashing us a signal. You see the reflection in there? Good morning. Yeah. Gary. There's one pond, and when the water is really active, it creates a waterfall that goes over that ledge. And there's a city off in the distance. 49 palms. Just another piece of California's gold. Feels so much cooler up here, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. See, hear people across the way. Well, this is it. 49 palms. We made it. We're gonna stop. I don't know. I'm gonna stop videotaping and start counting the palms. What's that? The booming? Yeah. So now we're coming back from the amazing 49 palms. Uh-huh. Okay, you can still do it for the base of the trail though, right? I'm gonna keep walking. Excuse me. Stay there, don't walk and do that. Right, I understand.
And tracks it. Very much like a GPS.
Mm-hmm.
Remind me next time.
Okay. Now remind yourself. Say, okay, Google. Uh-oh, coming to the end of the world. Uh-oh, uh-oh. Oh, there's a path after all.
Perfect temperature, really.
Mm-hmm. You want to go ahead of me? Why don't you go ahead?
Any warmer would be kind of hot.
I agree. Hello. Have you been there before?
No.
It's pretty. Have you been to the one in Anza Borrego?
No.
There's one there that's very pretty. This is nice, but it's a little smaller, but it's worth the hike. Whoops. Enjoy. Ta-da, the parking lot. I want to check something, just a moment. This part's so much less steep. Makes it pretty relaxing going back. The good news is that this direction feels really nice on your way back out.
I know. It's been a couple of years, but many more pounds heavier.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm dealing with. Thank you. Why don't you guys go on ahead of me? Hi.
Hey.
Fine. How are you doing? Yep. It's amazing how much more crowded it is with it being Martin Luther King Jr.'s birthday all weekend. But, well, last time we were here, of course, there was a sandstorm too. Lots of gravel covered stairs everywhere.
like probably right after high school.
Yeah. Oh, Pendleton. Yeah.
Hi there.
Do you
want to
get the remote
charger out? Sure. I always end up taking a lot of photos of these because I love them so much. Look, they just had the flowers.
Mm-hmm.
The flowers just bloomed. Looks like they just bloomed.
Hello. It's pretty the way the sun is shining on them. Look how tall some of these are.
I can't see one, but here's two.
And what should we know it to?
Desert wood rat. The builder of this nest, right here, is the desert wood rat, also known as a pack rat, for its habit of making all sorts of materials in its nest.
Okay. Some of these are taller than me. Here's a three coming up.
Silver trillium, really common cactus in Colorado Desert. Silver trillium. Like all trillia, the silver trillium has a woody supporting central stem. This tubular skeleton remains standing in place for years after the death and decay of the succulent portions of the cactus.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to get Carrie walking by the cactus, see how tall they are. Thank you for the animation. Look at this thing. Wait, Gary, stay by this one. No!
What?
He looked like he was touching it. Go ahead, Carrie, touch it. Let's see if they're really pokey. You're not going to, are you?
Oh, this is interesting. This has all kinds of sand stuck in it from like windstorms,
uh-huh.
I assume. Look at all the sand that's stuck in here from like windstorms.
Well, yeah.
So who's doing this?
Who's planting these?
Oh, people do that.
God. God is leaving prayers and rock. Oh, watch this.
The best thing to do with these is that.
Unless it's a true trail marker. We wouldn't do that on a true trail marker. Aren't those called cairns?
That was left here by the Indians 3,000 right. years ago. Here.
No, I don't think so.
Journey through time. Here on the edge of the Pinto Basin, we have a chance to give a piece of geologic time. The basin was formed when movement along the fault lines uplifted the surrounding mountains and the land between subsided. During the wetter time, the basin called a shallow lake.
It ain't a lake then. But still with that. Look at the little things that have fallen off the cactus. See the balls? The cactus balls? Look at all of them. Lots of them.
It is going to propagate. Look at these over here.
Yeah.
Where these have rotted and then they're little balls. The phoenix will rise. I've never seen these so thick before.
I'm looking for the cactus they're describing, which is the calico cactus, and I don't see it.
Can you show a picture of it?
It's like this.
Don't see it. Look at what it's like when it's, you can see the hollow part here.
Yeah, I think that's a newer trail.
Could be.
I don't remember being here before, and the parking lot looked kind of new, you know?
Mm-hmm. That platform over there looks new. They're almost glowing. And the sun shines on them.
I always get drawn to taking a lot of photos of these. They do almost glow. Especially when it's in the sun like this.
Right.
Look at that. It's amazing.
Mm. Isn't it just glowing?
Yeah. Shining on you.
I took out some of these.
They probably just...
This is creosote growth.
Mm-hmm.
Cactus are abundant only in places where water supplies are seemingly plentiful. Conditions exist in higher desert ranges and are many alluvial fans. So this is like a sort of alluvial fan, that's why it's...
Mm-hmm. Well, look, you can see how it stretches out into this huge valley.
Somewhere, if
they're
still here, is a
jojoba. Jojoba? Here's an eight. This, are you looking
That's
for eight?
That's what I read to you already.
Okay.
Alluvial fan.
Uh-huh. At some point, we need to do a picture of the three of us.
All right. Here, going that way. It's really good.